Indian writer who was a Christian, wrote 750 songs during the course of his lifetime. This particular song, when he painted it with such beautiful words, I don't know exactly what he was thinking about. Maybe he was thinking about God has helped him all of his life. And we look back at history and think how God has helped his people in all of their challenges. And so he decided to put it on paper. The second verse, it says, under the shadow of thy throne, thy saints have dwelt secure. Sufficient is thine arm alone, and our defense is sure. Oh, we should have confidence in this God. And just in case you're wondering, we're worshiping under the theme this morning of God and his people. God and his family. Believe and obey him, and we have peace. We are the people of God. We are the family of God. Against his confidence, against his backdrop, now let's pray. And every time we need prayer in this nation is now. I ask you to just hold hands with the one nearest to you. In agreement as we pray this morning, we want to pray for this nation. I know you believe that this nation needs prayers, and we want to pray for the government, and we pray for those who lead us, that they would not lead unto their own understanding, but allow God to guide us during these times. It's time of change. As we pray for those states to be restored that have been lost, and particularly we want to pray for lost souls. This is the time for men to get right with God now, during this season of changing things. Pray for the sick and the afflicted. God wants to restore some things, I believe. God wants to heal his people. He is our God and our Father. And we're glad for a chance to reach out to him. We want to pray for the service and pray for the pastor to bring the word, the sacrament of the word to us this morning. We pray that the Lord will be with us in his house, that it is not our will, but his will will be done in this place. We bow now and pray. Heavenly Father, in the name of Jesus, you are God, our Father. God, we understand we are your people. We are your family, and we give you praise and we give you glory. We thank you for this opportunity, this chance to worship you and honor you in this house today. We thank you for this chance to open up and to have you move in our midst as we give you praise and as we give you glory and honor. Spirit of God in the midst of us today. You're an awesome and an excellent God. We worship you. Our hearts are full because of your goodness. What we see, what we don't see, but we know your hands is upon it. And it rests, and it guides, and it protects. You are our defender. You are our covering in all of life's circumstances. And we give you praise in this house this morning for everything that we are. God, we bring this nation before you. That is going through enormous change. Things are changing all around. We understand, God, that of ourselves we walk about aimlessly and blindly. We cannot do or achieve anything of our own. So we seek you, God. We pray, oh God, that wisdom abounds and wisdom exists in government and those who lead us, God. That they'll understand, oh God, they should look under the hills for whence coming their help. But that the plants are north and they add to nothing if you are not in the midst of it. Father, give you praise, to give you glory, to have you once again ushered into the midst of us. testimony of Jesus Christ goes forth for men to change lives. Oh God, to change the very fabric of this society. That men and women will lean not unto their own understanding, but understand God. God, Jesus Christ is where life begins. Oh, we give you praise, we give you glory, we give you opportunity, because you have not forgotten your people. You're here with open ears to hear. You're here with open ears to bless, to heal, to touch, to restore in this nation. Oh God, we pray for the sick and afflicted. We pray for those in the family of God, those who will be away from us here now. Oh God, we're hoping that they could be, but they are afflicted. God, now I thank you that Jesus, there's nothing too hard for you to do. We pray, oh God, in accordance with your word and your truth. We pray, oh God, for the people of God who are believing in you, that by your stripes they shall be healed. That you will touch, heal, and make them whole. I pray particularly for those who are in this house today who may not say, Father, but are experiencing pain in their body, pain in their minds, who would be concerned and worried about their physical condition. I pray, oh God, even as they reach out to you in faith at this very moment, I pray, God, that you stretch forward with your healing hand. Spirit of God, move in the midst of your people this morning. Heal, restore, heal, make whole as they reach forward to you in faith. Heal in Jesus' name. Oh God, bless this service, every part of it. We turn it over to you. We come here with plans and expectations. Oh, but the perfect will of God is really what we want. The perfect will of God in this house today to do and say as you will. So we submit this service to you in every part of it. Bless the speaker, God. Bless the pastor. As he's been obedient and open himself to you to receive your word, God. Let his word go forward. Let your word go forward to do with your people. To do with your people. To do and touch your people as you see fit. Bless this house. Bless this house. We are your people. You are our God. Jesus is our Savior. And we're here to worship, to be blessed, to be strengthened. Do it now, Father, I pray. I pray right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And everybody.